This is a song I wrote for my daughter, Iolana. Iolana, do you wanna put on your pajamas and go down to the store with me? Iolana, do you wanna put on your pajamas and see what there is to see? Oh, see some cantaloupe
to eat.
We need us some more flowers
to smell.
We need us some more soy milk
to drink.
We need us some more cat food for the cats.
Iolana, do you wanna saddle up the llama and ride out the west with me?
Iolana, do you wanna saddle up the llama and
see what there is to see? Oh, we'll see some sunsets
so pink.
We'll see some canyons
so deep.
We'll sleep in the big trees
so green.
We'll swim in the waters oh so cool.
Botswana and see what there is to see. Oh, we'll play with the children.
So fun!
We'll ride on a camel.
Two humps, not one!
We'll try some new foods.
Yum, yum!
We'll send postcards to everyone.
Iolana, do you want to put on your pajamas and go down to the store with me?
Iolana, do you want to put on your pajamas and see what there is to see?
Oh!
For all of you out there, is one about a man from outer space who came to visit our lovely planet. But all these things were happening that were just contending to make his life miserable. This is a song about Radiation Man. When we say the words Radiation Man, then you at home put your arms up and go, ah, like that, okay? Here we go.
He came in a flying saucer. He landed in the middle of the day, in the middle of the little town. Oh, the silver side door open with a whoosh, bing, bang, clunk kind of sound. The people were running around. They were giant ants lost within their own reaction. Out came a shining silver man. Silver head, silver manicured hands. As he opened his eyes, he smiled with surprise at the sight before him. Without meaning any harm, eagerly waved
hello.
But as he did, he released a radioactive glow. Hey! Radiation Man.
Shocked when his secretary burst into the office screaming,
it's a giant silver man, and he's getting out of a silver frying pan.
Oh, they rushed outside to see an insane scene from a picture show. A silver saucer and a silver man, and bodies on the ground still smoking. Oh dear, what is this? He cried. Rams, they've all been fried.
Radiation Man. Radiation Man. Radiation Man.
You say
inside. He had to think for a while he had to hide. He rang up his sister Irene, a down-to-earth woman with the endowments of a homecoming queen. And Irene raced frantically down to the climatic square, where dead as the beat of a clock, her eyes locked on a silver hunk of man. Now this is what the spaceman saw, a multi-colored, multi-stack human package. He whistled loud and he whistled low. Irene turned as red as a Christmas bow, and Irene's heart fluttered in time to her lovely lashes. But the spaceman's kiss turned Irene's blissful body into a pile of ashes. Radiation man,
ah,
radiation man,
ah,
radiation man,
ah,
he's having a bad day,
day.
Radiation man,
ah,
radiation man,
ah,
radiation man,
ah.
Okay, here's the moral. So if you travel in space for business or pleasure, or to visit an alien race, just remember this tale of woe. For as I have mentioned, la 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 la, you could be well intentioned, or you could be the foe, simply by saying, yeah, you could be the foe, simply by saying,
how you doing?
I have to tell you, kids,
I'm
a sweaty mess right now. And you probably are, too, if you were at home jumping up and down and running around, jumping off the sofa. Whew, that is a hyperactive song. And I'd like to know that Radiation Man made it back home safe. He sent me several postcards, and he sends you his love. Now we're going to do a song called Pink on the Inside, because no matter where you go in the world, that's the truth. We're all pink on the inside.
As long as you keep the middle inside, 'cause
was scared. Be a yuppie wearing fancy pinstripe suits. You might be a hippie wearing love beads and Birkenstock shoes. It don't matter if you're fair. It don't matter where you've been. It don't matter as long as you roll and keep it both with both oars in. Cause when you drive it
today, and we have another special song for you. This is a song about a little bear and a little dog, and about the dog's biggest wish for winter a coming. And it's going to start off with a little bit of a medley at the top from Mr. John.
Walking in the woods, and he met up with the big brown bear. Well, the little yellow dog said, "Woo, woo, woo." Now that ain't no way to talk to a bird. Oh. But the little yellow dog, he didn't care. He was looking for a winter coat to wear. And he grabbed that dog by the scruff of his neck, and he shook him around like an old dish rag. Little yellow dog, ain't you had enough yet? But little yellow dog, he didn't care. He was looking for a winter coat to wear, and he liked the looks of that one.
Little dog, Sandy. moon, everybody. Look out. Okay. Now that we've sung a dog song, I think it's only appropriate to follow it up with a cat song. And this is a real cat song. This song was sent to me by my friend Anna Steinhagen, who was 3 when she and her mom wrote this together. And it's about a real cat.
What's that cat's name?
The cat's name is Louise. And they found it next to the freeway in Beaumont, Texas. And they saved it, John. They brought it home. And they fixed it all up, and now it lives with them. When I found my cat Louise, she was totally covered in fleas. So I gave her a bath, made her laugh, and she came to live with me. Louise, 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 I love my fat Louise. Louise,
Louise,
Louise, Louise, I love my fat Louise. My crazy cat Louise, she loves to eat everything but peas, cereal and feathers, pizza and sweaters, and yesterday she swallowed my keys. Louise,
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 I love my fat Louise. Louise,
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 I love my fat Louise. Louise, 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 she's such a great cat to squeeze. Funny cat Louise, she just loves to drink chamomile tea. She takes a few sips, then licks her lips and says, "Can I have some more, please?" A Louise,
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 I love my fat Louise. A Louise,
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 I love my fat Louise. One day my fat Louise, she frightened herself with a sneeze. She flew so high up in the sky and floated away on the breeze. Louise,
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 I love my fat Louise. Louise,
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 I love my fat Louise. Come on, everybody.
Louise,
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 I love my fat Louise. Louise,
Louise,
Louise, Louise, I love my fat Louise. Those of you at home that like klezmer songs, if you don't know what a klezmer song is, this is a song where you start really slow. You move around the room very slow, and then you get faster and faster. And this song is about Belinskys. Now, if you've never had a Belinsky, this tells you how to make one. So you can make one at home with your mom and dad, or your cousins, or your friends, or your grandparents, or your caregiver, whoever you're living with. It goes something like this. Some people choose a coffee, soda, or any kind of hot tea. But when I need a picker-upper, oh, I choose a Belinsky. Keeps me healthy.
Just take your juice, your favorite fruit, to keep it really tasty. Yogurt, apples, berries, cherries, nothing is too crazy. Oh, bop, 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 Balinski. The drink that keeps me healthy. Eggs and soy, protein powder, everything but yuck, clam chowder. Into the tender round it whirls, while I'm waiting round I twirl. I pour a drink for me and you. I give a shout. I jump around. I've got a Balinski. Ba 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 Balinski. Da 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 da. Drink that keeps me healthy. Just take your items, spin them round, pour them in the blender, chug them down. Be the laughing stock all over town. That's your red wagon.
Your red wagon.
Oh, your red wagon.
Your red wagon.
So just keep dragging your red wagon along. If you're sneaky, you know some things don't belong. Or don't you come to me if things go wrong. That's your red wagon.
Your red wagon.
Oh, your red wagon.
Your red wagon.
So just keep dragging. Singing the blues to me. That's your red wagon.
Your red wagon.
Oh, your red wagon.
Your red wagon.
So just keep dragging your red wagon along, Mr. Super Pal John Sanchez. Coming from you people at home. It's just waves of energy. Can you guys feel it? Oh man, I want to come to your house after the show and have some cookies, hopefully Girl Scout cookies, and a tall glass of cold milk. Doesn't that sound good?
Lemonade.
Or soy milk.
I'm pro soy, so. Or lemonade. Yeah, maybe we can have a lemonade sale later. The Super Pal Universe lemonade stand. That would rock.
Rock.
Okay. Okay, now we're going to do a little song called I Wish You Well, which I can hopefully do as I'm breathing. Whew, so heavily now. This is a song that I wrote for my friend Grace. When she was a very little girl, she got very, very sick. And a lot of people were really worried about her. And she had to go into the hospital. But fortunately, she had a lot of love and care from a lot of great doctors and nurses. And she's doing really great today. But while she was sick, I wrote her this song. And it's dedicated not only to Gracie, but to all of you at home and children all over the world.
Carousel to wish you well, spinning round and round, until you've ridden to your heart's content and hop back on the ground. I wish you well, I wish you love, oh, I wish you all I can. I wish you peace, I wish you hope, oh, until we meet my friends. And blessings to the birds I hear, the flying up above, bringing song into our lives, they're nestled in our hearts with love. I wish you well,
I wish you well,
I wish you love,
I wish you love,
oh, I wish you all I can. I wish you peace,
I wish you
hope,
I wish you hope,
oh, until we meet my friends. Oh, this old world can seem so bare, everywhere you go. But we can choose to become a friend with anyone we know. I wish you well,
I wish you well,
I wish you love,
I wish you love,
oh, you all I can. I wish you peace,
I wish you peace,
I wish you hope,
I wish you
hope, oh, until we meet my friends. Oh, I wish you well,
I wish you well,
I wish you love,
I wish you love,
oh, I wish you all I can. I wish you peace,
I wish you peace,
I wish you hope,
I wish you hope,
oh, until we meet my friends. I wish you well,
I wish you well,
I wish you love,
I wish you love,
oh, I wish you all I can. I wish you peace,
I wish you peace,
I wish you hope,
I wish you hope,
oh, until we meet my friends, oh, until we meet my friends.
Goodbye. Now we're going to do a song called Cantaloupe, so y'all can all come up here. I can put this down. Yeah, I'll go like this. Once about a time, I was in the kitchen, and I was making some cantaloupe slices for my kids, and this song just came out of nowhere, and here it is. There's a lot of cantaloupe lovers here today, my friends. Boom, 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 boom. Cantaloupe, boom, boom. Oh, I love cantaloupe. Just give me cantaloupe. Oh, I love cantaloupe. Oh, I would put it on a rope and I would swing it round my head and I would eat it every day. I'd eat it first thing out of bed. Just give me cantaloupe. Cause I love cantaloupe. Oh, there are days I just can't cope. Then I remember not to mope. Cause I have lots of juicy hope and I have cantaloupe. Just give me cantaloupe. I'd put it in an envelope and I would share it with the Pope. Except that he would just say nope. He won't eat cantaloupe. He don't eat cantaloupe. Oh, I could put it on the shelf and save it all just for myself, but it's more fun for you and me to share it with our family, cause we love cantaloupe. Just give us cantaloupe, cause we love cantaloupe. Oh, honeydew, 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 honey, 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 you at home too. Let's all hug them at home. Big hugs. That's right. If there's nobody sitting with you at the moment, just grab a pillow and squeeze it really tight. Do you ever feel like you want your parents' attention, but they're really busy? They're watching TV or reading the newspaper or talking on the phone or watching something on the computer, and you really want their attention. Well, this is a song you can learn, and then you can sing it to your parents when you need attention. And on my new record, my little girl Lily sings the song. So I don't do quite as good a job as she does, but I will try. Put down the paper, hang up the phone. Please see me as more than a dog. You throw a bone. Let's go for a walk. Yeah, let's go outside. No, I don't wanna hop in the car and go for a ride. I need a genuine encounter of the first degree. I need you to stop what you're doing and look at me. Look at me. Look at me, 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 look at me now. Look at me, 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 look at me now. Well, you're awfully busy. You've got things to do. Just give me a moment of time with you. I've got all these ideas I want you to see. 'Cause there's a person who's growing up inside of me. I need your full attention, and I deserve it too. I'm somebody important, I'm a part of you, a part of you. Look at me, 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 look at me now. Look at me, 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 look at me now. Look at me, 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 look at me. Don't be angry, I'm just a kid. I'm only doing the things that you once did.
All right, welcome here, kids. We have a very, very special show today. I'm sitting with a very, very special guest. This is Sarah Hickman, and I am very excited because I knew who Sarah was. I was telling her this beforehand, well before she knew me. I actually played her videos. She has videos here before. I've played her videos when I had to work from 3 to 8 in the morning, and they know all about that. I talk about it all the time because it was torture. But she's really been in the music scene for a while. I went to her website and checked out a few things, and I saw over 20 albums. She graduated from UNT, mm-hmm. So it's good to go to college even though you're a musician. That's for the high school kids out there.
And actually, I went to school for painting.
For painting.
And I made music to pay for all my painting supplies. So you know, you can be multi-diverse, multi-talented, and go to college, and then get a whole another degree, you know? So you can use, like, I was an English minor. I used my English, I used my painting, and I used my music all together.
And I started out in English, so we have something in common there. Wow. I was going to ask you, you just came out with your third children's music album, right? And it's called Big Kid, or that came out in 2003 at the end?
It just was released nationally 2004, February 10th.
What?
Just recently.
Oh, just recently. Mm-hmm. Okay. What originally inspired you to write children's music?
Well, actually, I've always felt very childlike, and I mean that in the best way. You know, some people think childish or being childlike is a sign of silliness, but I think it's having a really good heart and really enjoying your life. So when I had my first child, Lily, a lot of this enthusiasm for life started coming out in these little songs I would make up for her. And then some of the women in some of my mom's groups would say, oh, you're so lucky that you can sing to your daughter. And I would say, well, you can sing. And they would say, no, I can't. And I'd say, yes, you can. And then I thought, well, I'm going to make a CD, which was newborn, and then give it to people, and they can play it. And then when they get confident that they can sing, they can turn me off and make up their own songs for their kids. And that was kind of the start of me doing children's music. And that CD did so great that I decided I would do a box set. So I'm in the middle of making a whole box set for kids.
Very, very nice. Mm-hmm. Now, you started your career as a kid, right?
Uh-huh.
I think you were 14.
Oh, younger than that.
It was in Houston, Texas. Oh, really?
I was actually 7.
It was just your voice and a guitar.
Mm-hmm.
Where were you when this all started?
I know what you're talking about.
Yes,
so I'll talk
okay,
about that in a
okay.
second. Well, when I was 7, I was taking piano lessons, and my teacher was kind of like Marge Simpson. She had really big hair, and we would sit in this little concrete room with no windows, and I would get very claustrophobic, which just means like I felt really like all mushy inside. I didn't like it. I didn't want to really be there in the room. So my mom said, well, you can learn a different instrument then. So we went to the store, and I fell in love with the guitar. That was it.
Me too.
You too? And
I love
it. Did you come home from school every day and just run to your guitar and sit in a room and just play and play and play and play and play?
For the first year, I don't think I left it. I just was married to it for the first year.
Yeah, it was like my best friend. I used to ride my bike and play my guitar. I learned to ride my bike and balance without using the handlebars. And
don't try
I went everywhere. Yeah, don't try that. But anyway, so I started playing when I was 7. I went on stage at 7. I wrote my first song, and I won this little award from the Daughters of the American Revolution. And when I was on stage, this wonderful thing happened. I got to be on this, back then it was in an elementary school with one of those big radio mics, a big silver mic. And when I got on the mic, everything got loud and everybody got quiet. And then when I finished singing my song about the bald eagle, everybody clapped. And I thought, this is really neat that I can express myself and people reciprocate. And so that was the start of my music career. And then when I was 14, I got my first paid gig, as we like to say. For the Houston.
Was it Astros?
No.
No Oilers?
Yes,
really?
Back when it was the Houston Oilers.
Awesome.
And Earl Campbell was there. You probably don't remember.
Yes, I remember.
You're
Earl
much younger. But it was exciting. Yeah. I was the smallest person at this this private party for the Houston Oilers, and I would walk around with my guitar and sing songs. And then at the end of the night, I got paid a really big check, and I thought I could go buy a house or a car with it, which wasn't really that much, but it was exciting at the time.
Well, you actually, I read that you actually have been doing something or done something for the Romanian Orphans Fund. You've actually been over to Romania and worked with children in that country.
Yes.
Could you describe something, what that was like a little bit?
Well, Romania is a really beautiful country, but it's been devastated by past, I'm going to say dictators, which is what they were. And so people were taxed really heavily, and so they're very poor there. And they had a lot of children, and because they were so poor and they had so many children, a lot of the children would end up in orphanages or on the streets. And so they have an enormous problem with all these unwanted children. So I went over to take them clothes and toys and coats and socks and shoes and all kinds of things. And it was very sad. It made me want to come back to America. First of all, it made me really grateful to live in such a wonderful country, and but it made me realize that we all have a duty to take care of children all over the world who are suffering. So for the last 10 years, twice a year I send boxes of clothes and goods and things that they need over there. And people have been great. They bring stuff to my office or to my shows. They bring diapers and clothes and toys and all those things.
Awesome.
And then I send them over there, and it's the Tanner Romanian Mission is the group I work with now. I've worked with 4 different groups now, and and they are building homes, and they take in the most severely challenged children, children that no one will ever adopt because they're handicapped or hurt.
Hopefully that'll inspire some of the people watching to get involved in something, because it is always nice to reach out beyond yourself. And what's interesting about this show is that we have such a wide audience. I mean, we've got probably 2-year-olds watching and 82-year-olds watching, so it's really, really cool.
And it's fun, because even in your own school, sometimes there's children that need things in your own school, and you can find out kind of quietly, because you don't want to embarrass anyone, who in your school needs things, or they, in most schools, they have a closet where you can donate things that you're not using at home anymore, books or toys or clothes, and they'll put them in that closet, and then families that need extra things can go in that closet and take what they need. And so it's a very easy form of giving, and also Half Price Books has a really great program where you can take in your gently used books, and they build half pint libraries all across the United States for children in hospitals.
Awesome.
And so kids get to keep those books and take them home.
Very cool. I also noticed that despite everything you've been involved with in the last however many years, that
400 years, I'm very old.
You made it very clear that you loved chili cheese fries. And
green chili cheese fries.
That you bowled a 197, which is remarkable, kids. Yeah. Remarkable.
Yeah, if you could just pick up the ball, that's remarkable, because they're really heavy.
Okay, we got a little bit of time left here. I wanted to pump something really quickly. www.sarahhickman.com. It's that simple, right?
Or
SARAHICKMAN. It'll be on the screen here I'm talking about it.
Or they can also go to www.superpaluniverse.com, and they can download pictures I've drawn of Pillow Man, who's one of my superheroes, and then they can color them in.
Awesome. And well, what else would you like to say while we have Austin Kids or their captivation?
Well, you know what I think is, while we have them captivated,
while we have them
by
captivated,
your beautiful smile and our enthusiasm,
your beautiful smile, what would you say to them?
You know, my grandma used to say this to me all the time, and I thought it was really good advice. She told me two things. She said, never say shut up. I think that's very important. If you feel compelled to say that, you can always say hush up or shh or be quiet. And she also told me to always use dental floss. And I think that that is a very important thing, because, and your dentist will tell you, when you floss, you clean in between your teeth, and it keeps your teeth healthy and they don't fall out. So I would say those two things are really important to
talk
about.
I would say that I could use that advice myself sometimes. Well, thank you very, very
thank
much,
you.
Sarah, for
so
coming.
Nice to meet
and
you, Ryan.
Thank you for sharing your music with us.
Sure.